Hello students, this is your English lesson. Today we are going to read unit number 13, The Nawab of Salimabad 2 from Oxford Modern English 3. So we start our lesson. This is page number 119 from your book. What's to know? Commander, an officer in charge or in command of a military unit. Your Majesty. A form of addressing a ruler. Act 2, Scene 1. Storyteller. After some months, the Nawab called for the commander of the cavalry and told him to bring Salim, Hamid and Irfan before him. Nawab, when I was on my travels, I visited your parents. They are getting old and need some help. Would you like to leave my service and go home to your village? Hamid, we should. Indeed, in fact. Actually, sir. Salim, we have not seen our parents for 10 years. Irfan, but we have been proud to serve in your cavalry. Nawab, thank you for your service. But now you are free to go. Take this box of gold coins to your parents as a present and thank your mother for feeding me. Her onions are the finest in the kingdom. Act 2, Scene 2, Storyteller. The three sons returned to their home. Their parents were overjoyed to see them again. Their sons would be able to help them on the land. But the old woman went to the corner of the room. She filled a large basket with onions and off she went with the basket on her head to the Nawab's palace. She entered the palace with great difficulty. At last she was brought before the Nawab. Farmer's wife, falling on her knees, we did not know it was you who came to our house, your Majesty. Nawab, I learnt much from you, dear lady, and your onions tasted so good. Farmer's wife, thank you 1,000 times, your Majesty. Nawab, I hope your sons are now helping you at home. Farmer's wife, they are. Thank you for sending them back home. I have brought you some onions as a present. Nawab, thank you. And here is a box with 100 gold mohurs in it. Take these, not as a payment for the onions, but as a present. Act 2, Scene 3, Storyteller. The old woman was delighted, happy, and went home. On the way, she met the local money lender and told him the story. If the Nawab gives 100 gold coins for some miserable onions, thought the money lender, what will he give for a better gift? The money lender went to the palace to try his luck. Servant, sir, this man wishes to speak with you and present you with a gift. Nawab, who are you? Money lender, I am a money. A businessman, sir. Yes, a businessman. I have brought you a gift. Nawab, how kind. And what is it you have brought? Moneylender, a fine horse, your Majesty. It is just outside. Nawab, how kind you are. And in return, please accept a gift from me. The Nawab whispers to the servant. The servant goes out and comes back with a large box. Nawab, open this when you get home. It contains a very valuable present which costs 100 gold coins. Moneylender, thank you, sir. Thank you. The moneylender leaves the Darbar hall with the box. When he comes outside, he opens the box. Moneylender, what are these? Onions? Oh, no. Gave the Nawab a fine horse and he has given me a box full of onions. Now come to exercises. A. Comprehension. Answer the following questions. A. How did the Nawab meet the farmer's three sons? Answer. The commander of the cavalry was ordered to bring the three sons to see the Nawab. B. Who felt proud at serving the Nawab? Answer. the three sons felt proud to serve the Nawab. See, what did the farmer's wife give to the Nawab? Why? Answer is, the farmer's wife gave a basket of onions to the Nawab. She wanted to thank the Nawab. D. What did the old lady receive as a present? Answer. The old lady received a box full of gold coins as a present. E. Did the moneylender get a valuable present? Answer. The moneylender did not get a valuable present. He got a box of onions. These questions are more difficult. Discuss them first. F. Why do you think the Nawab sent the boys home? Answer. The Nawab sent the boys home to look after their parents. G. What kind of a man was the Nawab? Answer. He was a great man and a good ruler. 2. Complete the following sentences in your own words. A. After some months, the Nawab called the three sons. B. Your onions are the best I have ever tasted. C. When I was on my travels, I met your family. D. The old woman was very grateful for the present. E. Tell him to bring a packet of milk. F. I am going to visit northern areas in summer vacations. G. Are you not angry with me? H. Thank you. Thank your mother for a delicious breakfast. 3. Answer the questions about these lines taken from the story. A businessman. Sir, yes, a businessman. I have brought you a gift. A. Who speaks these words? Answer. The moneylender. B. To whom are the words spoken? Answer. To the Nawab. C. Why does the speaker repeat the word businessman? Answer. The moneylender nearly tells the Nawab that he is a moneylender. Then, when the word is half out, he stops. He realizes that the Nawab will think if he is a moneylender, he has plenty of money. So he changes the word to businessman and repeats it to make sure the Nawab has heard properly. D. What gift has he brought and why? Answer. He has brought a horse because he thinks the Nawab will then give him an even more valuable present in return. B. Working with words. 1. Fill in the blanks with one of the words given in the box. Neigh, howl, hiss, trumpet, hum, roar. A. Two or three bees started to hum near his ear. B. In the distance, he could hear a wolf howl. C. Have you ever heard a horse? Neigh. D. A cobra reared his head at him and began to hiss. E. Last weekend in the zoo, we heard the lions roar. F. I heard an elephant trumpet in the jungle. C. Learning about language. 1. Add not to the following sentences. You may have to make some other changes too. A. The wazir talked to the woman. The wazir did not talk to the woman. B. I have brought him a present. I have not brought him a present. C. The moneylender traveled home. The moneylender did not travel home. D. The old woman wishes to see you. The old woman does not wish to see you. E. You said they were good onions. You did not say they were good onions. 2. Complete the chart using the correct form of the verbs. A. Get, got, goat. B. See, saw, seen. C. Find, found, found. D. Come, came, come. E. Shake, shook, shaken. 3. Use suitable adverbs in place of the underlined words. Hurriedly, bravely, well, badly, quickly, beautifully, slowly, easily. A. He did some work which was not very good. He did some work badly. B. She did something without any difficulty. She did something easily. C. He fought against the enemy without any fear. He fought against the enemy bravely. D. He walked a mile in 9 minutes. He walked a mile quickly. E. He ate his breakfast in 2 minutes. He ate his breakfast hurriedly. Thanks for listening. For new videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you like my videos, please share and like.